Thank you, everybody. We are going to get started. All right, so hi, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us today for YouTube's Indie Week workshop, Everything You Need to Know Now. Today's class is going to showcase YouTube's current role in the industry. We're going to go over some product updates and then talk about YouTube's new multi-format release strategy during all the different stages of an artist's release. So before, during, and after. So I'm so excited you're here today. I want to introduce you to who is going to be speaking with us. Maybe not. Okay. All right. So my name is Britt Hicks. I'm a strategic partner manager in artist development here in New York City. I work with artists and their teams of all different sizes, of all different genres, to teach them how to utilize YouTube's products, as well as how to engage their fans on the platform and grow monetization. I've actually sat in the seat a lot of you are in. I started at a major label and went over to an indie. So I really wanted to bring that knowledge here to YouTube to help really shape our educational tools so that they can be beneficial to you and your artists. Next up, I have my colleague Zeeshan.
Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Zeeshan Merchant. I am a partner operations manager working exclusively with independent labels and distributors. I'm based here in New York City, but I work with labels across the US and Canada. Unlike the Britneys behind me, I am on the operational and technical side of things, so I handle everything from rights management to content delivery, product adoption, and honestly, everything in between.
Hi, I'm the other Brittany. I am a strategic partner manager in label development at YouTube. I work with independent labels, distributors, and media companies. Much like Britt and Zeeshan, my role here is to help partners maximize their potential on YouTube, and I like to focus on business growth, monetization, and release strategy.
Cool. So let's jump into the agenda for today. So we're going to be going over a quick overview of YouTube, like I mentioned, as well as some product updates, and then the multi-format strategy of an artist, which is pre-release, during, and after. And then we are going to be leaving you with a take-home resource and then opening up the floor for a Q&A with the three of us, which you can line up at the mic at the end. We are going to present a ton of information. We want to be sure everybody doesn't feel panicked taking notes. We will have some times that you can actually pause and take photo of the slides. You can take those resources home with you, as well as giving you some take-home resources at the end. As a friendly reminder, if you do have questions, please be sure to write them down so that we can get to them at the end. All right, so with that, we are going to jump into an overview of YouTube with Brittany Schneider.
Awesome. So as many of you may know, YouTube is building the best music ecosystem on the planet. We have over 2 billion music fans listening monthly, over 100 million songs globally, and we are the largest artist-to-fan platform. And since YouTube sits under the Google umbrella, we have a bunch of different stakeholders like Shorts, Nest, Maps, Pixel, and so much more. Today's biggest artists found their audiences on the world's largest stage, YouTube. YouTube is available in over 100 countries and across 80 languages, providing artists with the unique opportunity to tap into massive audiences and deep music engagement. With our global reach, more than 500 hours of content are uploaded to YouTube every minute. With every upload, this means more opportunities for your music to be heard. We are happy to share that YouTube Music and YouTube Premium are now available in over 90 countries and regions. So as you can see here, there are so many ways that artists can monetize on YouTube. We have ads, YouTube Premium, Super Chat, Super Stickers, Super Thanks, Creator Music, Merch, Ticketing, and Brand Connect, just to name a few. As long as the channel is monetizing, either through the YouTube Partner Program or being rolled up to a network, you have access to all of these features. So YouTube is investing in our products to help artists establish their footprint on the platform. Music discovery, shorts, marketing programs, live products, and music analytics are just some of the investments that we're making. Next, I'll give a brief overview of the resources YouTube provides artists and their teams. I recommend writing these upcoming links down, but we'll also throw them back up towards the end. So the YouTube for Artists website. Here is where you can find answers, best practices, playbooks, success stories from artists themselves, and learn how to make the most of YouTube's global platform. You can find this website at artists.youtube, and it's available in 21 languages. The YouTube for Songwriters Hub provides all of the educational guides and best practices tailor-made for songwriters and producers to thrive on YouTube. This can be found on YouTube for Artists website in the Songwriters Hub or at artists.youtube/songwriters. We also offer music masterclasses. Music Masterclass is a series of scaled, educational, in-depth workshops designed to help our partners thrive on YouTube. Educational topics include release strategy, analytics, optimization strategy, and more. If you're interested in attending, be sure to talk to your distributor or YouTube partner manager. Most recently, we held a masterclass on YouTube analytics. You'll soon be able to watch the recording of this session on the YouTube for Artists website. The Music Insider Program is a series of educational summits where YouTube executives and external speakers share the latest and most insightful updates on YouTube's business and products. These events are meant for music industry partners under NDA. Attendees include C-level executives and day-to-day practitioners. Please reach out to your distributor or YouTube partner manager if you're interested in being invited. We also have Lior's Letter. This monthly email newsletter from YouTube's global head of music, Lior Cohen, to the music industry touches on key topics, news, YouTube initiatives, and it's one of the best ways to be the first to know what we are up to. If you'd like to sign up, you can scan the QR code and fill out the form to request to join the newsletter. This sign-up form will also allow you to sign up for YouTube weekly charts emails if you so choose to. If you didn't get a moment to scan, we'll toss the QR code back up at the end. The YouTube Help Center is the most comprehensive database of articles, from troubleshooting to optimization on everything YouTube. This hub has all the answers. It's actually amazing. You can find this at help.youtube.com. This is such a valuable resource that even we at YouTube often use this as a first line of defense when we encounter issues or need some additional help troubleshooting to find information and resources to ensure that your issue is resolved. The YouTube Creators Channel is for whether you're just starting out or you want to take your channel to the next level. This channel can help you make great videos, grow your channel, earn revenue, and get closer to your community with free online courses and lessons. This channel is a great resource to send to artists, management, or even coworkers for walkthrough tutorials. You can find this at youtube.com/YouTube Creators. And we have the YouTube blog. Here you can read artist stories, stay up to date on our latest product news, and learn about all the ways you can get the most out of your YouTube presence as an artist. You can find this at blog.youtube. This is also a great resource for case studies to see what's working right now for artists. So now passing it on to Zeeshan.
Thank you so much. And when Brittany said that YouTube Help is a totally, like, we use it for everything, even on our side, I think I have that thing memorized by now. So definitely recommend checking that out. Cool. We're going to run through a few more resources, and then we'll stop to give you an opportunity to take pictures of all of the links. So for those of you that don't know, YouTube Studio is essentially the backbone of your channel. Here you can access a ton of different resources on top of all of your content. Things like analytics, a dashboard that provides an overall health check of your channel, as well as personalized and customized insights on product and platform updates. One of the great tools that we offer at YouTube is Analytics for Artists. This is a tool that we built specifically with the music industry in mind. Here you'll be able to see how things are working on your channel, who's engaging with your content, and how they're engaging with your content to really influence your release strategy. If you think about Analytics for Artists as a personalized view of how your content is doing on the platform, you can think about Music Charts and Insights as how all content is doing on YouTube. This is a great view into what is performing well within the overall music ecosystem on YouTube. You can see what's trending, top songs, top artists, and top music videos. All of this is accessible at charts.youtube.com. And for anyone that's looking to optimize their channel on YouTube or, you know, just learn a little bit more about how to our best practices, I think that our music certifications are a great opportunity. This is a great way to learn about how to optimize your channel, and we try really hard to keep these up to date on our latest product updates. So we actually are launching a new course later this year, which we're really excited about. I know we just went through a ton of different resources, so I'm gonna stop here to give you all an opportunity to take a picture of this slide or write down any of the links that feel relevant to you. I see a lot of phones, that's a good sign. We have a QR code at the end. Yep. Cool. Everyone good? Awesome. Now let's take a moment to jump into platform updates. Here we'll take a look at everything that's been going on with YouTube overall. So first and foremost, we're going to dive into some of the numbers that really talk about the growth of YouTube as a platform. Now, as I'm sure you all know, YouTube is absolutely a massive platform. With 2 billion monthly logged in users, billions of hours of video uploaded every month, and billions of views being generated on this content, YouTube is a massive opportunity for artists of all different sizes. And it's continuously growing. In 2022, we had more people create content on YouTube than ever before. This is one of the main reasons why Lior and our global team has made it our very public goal to be the number one revenue source to the music industry by 2025. I think a testament to that is the fact that up to June 2022, we have paid out $6 billion to the music industry in the 12 months prior. To give you an idea of the level of growth that we're seeing, we paid out $4 billion in the year prior, giving a 50% growth year over year. Two things that I think are really interesting about this is that 30% of that growth is coming from user-generated content. This really is a testament to the fact that YouTube is a fan-centric platform, and it really is an opportunity for your artists to engage with their fans and audience directly. And back in September of 2022, we hit 80 million subscribers on music and premium, including trialers, and Lior made this awesome short to celebrate that milestone. He really is a character. That feels like a great opportunity to transition to talk about the state of YouTube Shorts today. Now, we've seen an absolutely massive explosion with Shorts. Launching back at the end of 2021, these numbers are honestly really hard for me to wrap my head around. We're now seeing 50 billion views a day on Shorts, with 1.5 billion of our logged in users looking at Shorts every month. Something that we on the music team thought was really interesting is that 50% of artists that are posting Shorts saw subscribers come directly from Shorts posts rather than just their long form. Kind of doubling down on that, artists that tap into Shorts saw their audience of unique viewers grow by more than 80%. This really feeds into our belief that when combined, short form and long form video make YouTube an extremely powerful engine for artists and their audience. We've seen that artists that use both Shorts and long form are getting better watch time and subscriber growth overall compared to those that are just using long form. When you add in streaming, analytics, and everything else that the YouTube music ecosystem has to offer, YouTube is really a unique place that allows artists to drive discovery and engage with fans on a one-to-one basis, unlike any other platform. I'll now pass it back to Brittany and Brittany to talk about release strategy.
All right, thanks, Zeeshan. So the Brits are gonna walk you through YouTube 101 for Artists new release strategy. As a friendly reminder, if you have questions that come up during this section, please write them down so we can be sure to get to them at the end. So we at YouTube are focused on providing the best educational materials to help our artists thrive on the platform. So today we're excited to share the new release strategy and best practices with everybody. There are a ton of different ways to approach, but these are our top recommendations. Before we get started, Brittany S. is gonna hop back up here with me, and we're gonna go over the three different stages that we're gonna dive into today.
So we know that it can sometimes be really overwhelming when it comes to utilizing the right features at the right time, which is why we wanted to share this overview with you. This overview covers the available features to help you maximize your opportunity on YouTube for your releases, and we'll discuss each of these columns in more detail. The key takeaway on this slide is that we have been and will continue to help provide the most relevant features to help you succeed on YouTube. So passing it back to Britt H. to kick it off with the pre-release strategy.
Awesome. All right, so let's talk about what you can do during the pre-release stage. In this stage, the biggest thing we recommend for you to do is focus on making sure you have a strong foundation and you're building anticipation for the release. So a strong 24 hours can potentially earn your video extra views. So you want to be sure you lay that foundation for release day. To help you do this, we recommend you update your branding, upload your videos, and set premiere and trailer, set up live redirect, and build anticipation with shorts. So let's break each one of these down. So first off, let's start with updating your branding. We recommend utilizing these top five branding update strategies when you're at least 1 week away from a new release. So first, update your channel banner to include what you want your fans to know, like the release day or the name of the new song. This is extremely important as now we're seeing a lot of new fans come over from discovery platforms like Shorts, and if they come to your page, you want them to know what the next big thing is. Next, add your social links to be sure fans can connect with you on all of your platforms. Also, update your about page with information, maybe like your timeline, your contact information, the city you're based in, or even tour information. The contact, I think, is one of the best features that you can also add, as a lot of artists are now finding each other on social platforms because it opens a door for that fostering a different type of communication and hopefully collaboration down the line. Next up, you can also select a featured video for your channel as well as customize your channel layout. All right, so once you have updated your branding, let's move on to the next stage of setting up premiere and trailer to help build anticipation for the visual release that's going along with the audio. So premiere allows you to create buzz and accelerate the velocity of a new video on YouTube. A shareable watch page will be created when you set up a premiere, so it's a great way to drive excitement before the new video drops because you can share that on all of the artist's socials. That also then creates one landing spot for all the fans from every different social channel to come to one place and enjoy a big moment of an artist's career together. Next is trailer, which is exactly what it sounds like. It's a short video that teases your release ahead of time. So trailer lives on the premiere watch page, and it's like what you see on the bottom right hand of the screen here. It elevates the moments before premiere, and it creates a lot of hype for fans on what's to come. So before I move to the next slide, I'm going to answer one of the number one questions we get, which is, what time should I release a video? So we have a few data-driven recommendations for two different types of scenarios. So the first scenario is, if the video is ready at the time of the audio release for an artist, we recommend that you release them at the same time. It tends to be more impactful on overall video reach, consumption, and engagement on YouTube based on our research. But we know it happens. If your video is not ready at the time of your release, what you can actually do is utilize analytics for artists that Zeeshan mentioned earlier. So in analytics for artists, there is an audience tab that shows active hours, which is going to show when your audience is most online. You can take a look at that and then schedule your video within that time to be sure that you maximize your reach. After all, remember that the initial viewership and engagement metrics like click-through rate and likes matter a lot for distribution. All right, the next feature I'd like to share here is live redirect. So essentially what this feature allows you to do is set up a live stream as a pre-show to build hype for the upcoming premiere. Think of it kind of like a red carpet before a big show, but it's virtual. A few tips to ensure you have a successful live redirect is to tell fans what is happening beforehand. Promoting that pre-show URL link on all of your socials so that you can bring fans to one place. Taking a few minutes of the live stream to hype up the premiere and set expectations with your fans on what they are going to see. Now, one of the most important steps, and if you're taking notes, I would start this, is to make sure that artists are communicating to fans to stay on this video premiere page. What's actually going to happen is the live redirect will automatically forward over to the video premiere page. Fans don't have to do anything. So if you are doing this, we highly recommend your artists communicate to their fans, don't touch anything, stay put, and we will all get redirected over to the video premiere together. All right, so a quick poll to see who was paying attention earlier in the beginning. So true or false, artists who are uploading both shorts and long form videos are seeing better overall watch time and subscriber growth. So raise your hand for true. Raise your hand for false. All right, smart group, it is true. So we've really seen artists who incorporate that multi-format strategy of both long form and short form content are seeing a better overall watch time and subscriber growth. So we really recommend you keep this in mind as you're leading up to your release day. So with that, let's jump into release day with Brittany Schneider.
Thanks, Britt. So now that we've covered the pre-release strategy, let's move on to the release day. So keep the momentum going. Remember, on this day, we want you to celebrate the great work that you've done to reach this point while also staying engaged with your fans. So during the premiere, it's important to be present and engage with your audience. We recommend you educate yourself on the best practices for live chat, including the following recommendations that you see here. Like enabling live chat replay, you can do this from the YouTube studio, and this will really help viewers that missed the premiere feel like they're still a part of it. You can encourage and engage fans' questions in the chat, and you can also use moderators to find and reply to comments. It's very important to thank viewers who showed up to support you by hearting their comments or replying to them. We also recommend announcing your release with our other engagement features like community and across your social platforms. And lastly, be sure to pin the release as the featured video on your channel, as it'll continue to drive views long after the release date. Around the time of your release, you can also utilize shorts to promote your release and encourage fans to make their own shorts using your music. Some suggestions of strategic release initiatives are creating shorts using your music from the audio library. You can do this by tapping Add Music in the Shorts camera, searching for your music in the audio library, and adding the music to your short. You can view all the shorts using your track on the sound page. As seen here, the sound page can be opened by clicking on the lower right corner of the short. It's important to engage with fans that created shorts by thanking them in their comments. You can also add video chapters at a specific timestamp of your official video to encourage shorts creations with your music. Question time. Another poll. So let's say you created a short. You want to add your new song as the audio. So you use the shorts audio picker to find and add the official audio to your short, and then you post it. So true or false, if a fan taps the audio on the short, they will go to the short sound page, which will feature a video with the full-length version of the song. Raise your hand for true. Raise your hand for false. Raise your hand for hesitancy. The answer is true. So if the sound recording asset is embedded in the official video, the video will be displayed at the top of the short sound page. If there isn't a video asset for the sound, the art track will be displayed instead. So let's take a look. Oh. Yeah. So here's a quick look at what you would see if you tap the audio square on the lower right corner of the short. It'll take you to the short sound page, which we have also redesigned with a new, larger video thumbnail in the header, which links out to play the official music video or art track. This will also drive more consumption and direct users back to your official artist channel. So now let's take it back to Britt Hicks to wrap us up in the post-release phase.
Awesome, thanks. And want to extra highlight what Britt just said with that short sound page. That is one of, I think, the best features that YouTube offers that is unlike any other platform. Because what you're going to see is you're going to have passive fans who might be scrolling. They can tap on that audio and then go explore all of the long form content, including music, that that artist has delivered. So you're kind of turning a passive scroller into a potential long-term fan. So super important that you're utilizing that shorts audio picker to add that official audio to an artist's short. All right, let's get into the final post-release stage. So the goal in this stage is to keep things going by keeping viewers engaged so that way we can reach more fans. So some of the ways we can do that is experimenting with different formats, engaging fans using shorts, and thanking fans by sharing their videos. All right, so first let's talk about experimenting with formats. Fans want ways to get to know the artist a lot more just beyond a music video. So some examples of sharing formats could be lyric videos, behind the scenes of the music video, even in the recording studio, and live streams. Our studies have actually found that behind the scenes videos can, in some cases, drive subscribers 2 to 3 times the rate of an official video. So be sure to incorporate this into your post-release strategy. Think of releasing different types of content to keep the momentum going. This also really extends the life cycle of a song and allows more opportunity for fan discovery, as well as giving current fans more exciting content. So let's take a look at what Ed Sheeran did here on the screen. After posting his video for Shivers, he followed up by posting a lyric video and an official music video. Sorry, official performance video. But that's not even close to how many formats he posted. If you take a look, he's also done the behind the scenes of the video, an acoustic version, and a couple other live versions. He actually started by posting the official video on September 9th and continued releasing all these versions for the next 2 months into November. So really continue that life cycle of a song and engaging fans. All right, so speaking of engaging fans, one of the best ways you can do this is by thanking them directly. So you can thank fans directly by commenting on their videos or giving them a quick shout out in a video or a short. Fun tip, you can actually quickly answer comments in the YouTube studio. When you log in on the left-hand side, there's a comments tab. You can tap that, and you can even filter your comments based on ones that you have or have not answered to ensure that you get to talk to all of your fans. On short specifically, you can duet their short or even react, or now you can actually even use one of their comments that they left on your short and make another short out of that, which fans love and get very excited about. You can also create a channel link within your channel and link your favorite fan videos there. To help you do this, you can utilize YouTube Studio to find the most popular videos and shorts that include your music. And lastly, you can share fan videos on the community tab and socials. These are all really easy, no-cost ways of amplifying your releases, helping artists reach new fans, and increasing song total views. Next up, you can leverage the power of shorts. As I mentioned, you can engage with your fans using shorts in so many different ways. One of these ways is experimenting with different types of shorts, such as a dance video, an a cappella version, challenges, etc. You can even show your fans what to post or even just react to you reading their comments, or use the tip I mentioned earlier, make a short using their comments on your current videos. We recommend catching the viewer's eye in the first few seconds as you only have a quick moment to reel them in. So let's take a look at an example from the artist Rule and what he did. He dropped a preview of his song Growing Up Is and asked fans to finish the lyrics using hashtag #ShortsRule. As you test different types of content, you can go into your analytics in Analytics for Artists, which is in YouTube Studio, and you can see which shorts are performing the best and then lean into that niche. To learn more about what to post on shorts, we also have a ton of great resources on YouTube for Artists, where there are guides made by artists, there are guides made directly for labels. Everything you can hope for is there, so I highly recommend checking that out. All right, so our final poll of the day, true or false. When it comes to catching their eyes, with shorts, there's no need for strong audio or visual. Raise your hand for true, raise your hand for false. All right, couldn't get that one past you guys, so it is false. So shorts do need strong audio and visual to grab your attention. Be sure you use strong visuals in the first 3 seconds. And like we mentioned earlier, if the official audio is out, select that from the audio picker. All right, so we've covered a ton of incredible information today, so I want to be sure that you have resources to take with you and apply them on all of your artist releases moving forward. So this is the release checklist. It's probably a little bit hard to see, but don't worry. We have a QR code here that you can download and check out everything that you need to do before, during, and after an artist release. So please take a moment, scan this QR code on the screen so that you can have access to this checklist. Again, this checklist covers a lot of what we went through today. So we hope that it really helps you as you continue on your releasing journey. So I'll give everybody a minute to scan that. All right, so it's still on the screen, just a little smaller on the left-hand side. So here are the other QR codes that also came up during the presentation. If you didn't get a chance to scan them, please do. The middle one, you can sign up for Lyra's Letters, as well as YouTube Charts. And on the far right, you can view our YouTube Music Certification courses. Again, a lot of the information that we presented today can actually be found on the YouTube for Artists website, among a total different presentations and PDFs. There's master classes up there, there's short videos. Everything you could hope for is on our YouTube for Artists site. So we really appreciate everybody coming today, and we really hope you learned a lot, and we would love to answer any questions if you have them. We're gonna grab a seat and do so. And if you do have questions, please head on over to Mike on our right, and we will answer as many as we can. Thanks. Yeah.
Is this on? Oh, it is on. Cool. Hey, what's up? I'm Austin. I work for a company called Audio Tree. We film a lot of videos and put them on your channel. Is there any way or plans to do something similar to the way Instagram works with collaborative posts? Let's say an artist plays my show and I want to have it appear on their channel, or, you know, I have a short, you know, and there's a collaborative where it's like it notifies all of our subscribers and their subscribers as well. Is there a way to do that?
You can always create a playlist on the channel that you want to feature the video on, and then add that video to the playlist. It won't provide a notification to their subscribers, but it is a way to have the video featured on another channel.
Yeah. You can also share it across community as well. I know our team of engineers is constantly working to add new features, and that's been a hot feature that people have requested. So hopefully in the future we'll see some more developments in that realm, but as of right now, no. But okay. A really great solution is definitely doing playlists, sharing it on community, and also asking that artist to do cross collaboration in order to get it across too.
And I have one more question about the audio in shorts. We make a lot of content that's got, you know, synced to the live performance, but it doesn't get picked up automatically by the algorithm or whatever it is, like it does on a platform like Instagram. Is there plans to do something like that where, you know, our track appears in the bottom corner without us having to go through the YouTube tools to then meticulously sync it up where it is in the performance?
Yeah, so I can take this one if you guys want. There's actually a way to do it. It's a little bit of a hack right now. So Okay. It's not automated, but similar to other platforms, what you can do is go into the YouTube Shorts audio picker, select that audio and add it to the short, and turn the official audio all the way down. So Okay. It can be whatever the volume is that was originally on the short. So if it's a live performance, it might have been filming the music video. And when you tap on that short, it will still take you to the sound page with the official song audio.
All right. It's a hack.
Yeah. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, that's a hack. That's a big pro tip that we use a lot, and it has been really helpful for a lot of artists.
All right, cool. Well, I'll just leave that in the ether then. Maybe it'll happen in, you know, a few months. Thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Anybody else have any questions? All right, no pressure. Don't everybody run at once. Yeah, go ahead back there. No problem. There you go.
No, I think that's the only way to do it. We call them pivot pages, so it gives you an opportunity into like long form content and everything else, but you do have to click on that little icon.
No?
Cool.
Oh yeah, go ahead back there.
So you mentioned a lot about having multiple formats, so like weird videos, BTS, all the stuff. Is there a preferred
Totally.
I think it varies a lot from channel to channel, and like you kind of figure out what works best for your audience. I've seen some situations work where like you start with a shorts campaign and then you go into an official music video, and then after that you post lyric videos and behind the scenes. I've also seen the exact opposite work. So it depends on your audience, and I think experimenting is the best answer we can give there.
Yeah, I definitely would say too, I always recommend start with the official video if you have it and it's ready. And then I think giving it a little bit of space, you don't want to do it like the immediate day after, but if there's a demand, for instance, like there might be a song that's getting really large in lyrics and it's going globally, and you want to be sure that everybody can read the lyrics because there might not be somebody watching it in that native language, and you feel like you need to throw that up 3-4 days later, I think that's absolutely a great way to do it. In the case of the Ed Sheeran study, they had been doing them about every other week. So again, it really depends what the audience is consuming. I always recommend checking out the artist analytics because you can see where there's trigger points in the video. And if you could tell maybe your official video is kind of starting to go down, it might be sitting at like a very standard return rate, it might be time to, you know, toss another video on there and hopefully boost people if they see the next video you upload, it goes, it makes a chain reaction to the other formats. Yeah. Any other questions? Yeah. We're going to go back a lot of slides. By video chapters.
Yeah, so when you're creating video chapters, this can be easily done by just placing a timestamp starting at 0 in the description, and you could throw it at the bottom of the description so it's unseen. But then when you have a section in the music video where you would see potential for the sound to move on shorts, I would drop in the timestamp and then say a little blurb next to it of create a short with this sound or use this audio for a short. And then when people are scrolling through, it'll pop up as a chapter on the video. No, when you're putting the timestamp in, if you write a little comment next to it, that's what'll appear. It's also great for if you have any artists that are involved in podcasting, or let's say they upload a live performance video and there's multiple songs in it, you can use that to time out when every song starts. Of course.
All right, well, it looks, is there anybody else? Last call? Yeah. Yes, so it's on the YouTube for Artists website, which is just artist.youtube. We parsed a lot of this information across a multitude of our educational resources, but some of the decks I would definitely recommend is the Shorts 2023 Artist and Label deck, and then the Artist Release Strategy deck. They're both located if you go onto the YouTube for Artists website under the Resources tab, and there you'd be able to find a lot of this information, which hopefully will help you, and tons of other things. There's more in-depth on going live. There's in-depth on running ads, which are questions we get lots of. They're right there at your fingertips. Yeah.
Yeah, so there are a couple different requirements. I think primarily you have to have one track distributed by, like officially distributed, which creates a topic channel. And at that point, you should be able to integrate and create an official artist channel.
Like a personal channel.
Yeah, you can merge those as well. Just reach out to your distributor and they should be able to help you get that done.
Yeah, most distributors have a request form, actually, so if you're struggling to find it, I recommend Googling your distributor's name and typing in official artist channel request, and it typically comes up, and they can pretty easily do that for you.
Do you mean edit someone else's short that uses your sound?
Yep, I've done on the social platforms. You can request, I work for a distributor, you can request attribution. And it is like kind of a time consuming process on those other platforms. But just wondering if there's any way with YouTube to do that.
I think you can probably use the socials on the channel to reach out to them directly. And yeah, I feel like that would probably be your best bet. You're saying views contributing to charting?
Yes.
I don't know.
Yeah, that's a great question. I think that kind of goes into a larger conversation of not just YouTube, but other platforms, how that is going to charting. I imagine as things progress, especially with short form and long form content becoming such a large part of music, it could potentially happen, but we don't have anything. I don't have a solid yes or no for you on that right now, sadly. Yeah, of course. All right, last call. If not, I'll release everybody. Awesome. Well, thank you all so much for joining us. Really hope that you learned a lot. We'll be around. If there's anything specific you want to ask us, please come up. But if not, thanks again and enjoy the conference.